volunteer service. I wanted to call your attention two times that you will come to rail this evening. The first time is for an position of actors, and the second time will be for community service. Come for a concert during this. They are cited after the gospel, who will be in position of actors, so that is on page 10 of your bulletin to refer to that, and then our normal free concert during this. Bless the Lord, who forgives all our sins.
Bless the Lord, for all.
Please pray this call together. Almighty and everlasting God, you made the heaven and the earth, and forgive the sins of all who are living. Create and make us new and bright hearts, that we may worthily remind you of our sins, and acknowledge in our righteousness, may obtain of you, without all mercy, perfect permission for forgiveness. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen.
Please be seated for the last.
The first lesson is reading from the prophet Isaiah. Shout out, do not hold back. Lift up your voice like a trumpet. Announce to my people their rebellion, to the house of Jacob their sins. Yet day after day, they seek me and delight to know my ways, as if they were a nation that practiced righteousness and did not forsake the ordinance of their God. They ask of me righteous judgments that delight to draw near to God. Excuse me. Why do we fast, but you do not see? Why humble ourselves, but you do not notice? Look, you serve your own interests on your fast day and oppress all your workers. Look, you fast only to quarrel and to fight and to strike with a wicked fist. Such fasting as you do today will not make your voice heard on high. Is such the fast that I chose, a day of humble, a day to humble oneself? Is it to bow down the head like a bulrush and to lie in sackcloth and ashes? Will you call this a fast, a day of acceptance to the Lord? Is not this the fast that I chose, to loose the bounds of injustice, to undo the thongs of the yoke, to let the oppressed go free, and to break every yoke? Is it not to share your bread with the hungry and bring the homeless poor into your house? When you see the naked, to cover them, and not to hide yourself from your own kin? Then your light shall break forth like the dawn, and your healing shall spring up quickly. Your vindicator shall go before you. The glory of the Lord shall be your rear guard. Then he shall call, and the Lord will answer. He shall cry for help, and he will say, "Here I am." If you remove the yoke from among you, the pointing of the finger, the speaking of evil, if you offer your food to the hungry and satisfy the needs of the afflicted, then your light shall rise in the darkness, and your gloom be like the noonday. The Lord will guide you continually and satisfy your needs in parched places, and make your bones strong. And you shall be like a watered garden, like a spring of water, whose waters never fail. Your ancient ruins shall be rebuilt. You shall rise up the foundations of many generations. You shall be called the repairer of the breach, the restorer of streets to live in. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The song for this evening is Psalm 103. We will say a song in unison. Bless the Lord, O my soul,
and all that is within me, bless His holy name. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all His benefits. He forgives all your sins, and heals all your infirmities. He redeems your life from the grave, and grants you with mercy and loving kindness. He satisfies you with benefits, and your needs, and your needs. The Lord executes righteousness, and does it for all who are oppressed. He made His way known to Moses, and His works to the temple of the children of Israel. The Lord is full of compassion and mercy, slow to anger, but great kindness.
You will not always deceive us,
nor will we keep His anger forever. He has not dealt with us according to our sins, nor rewarded us according to our wickedness. For the heavens are high above the earth, so is His mercy great upon those who fear Him. As far as the east is from the west, so far has He removed our sins from us. As a father cares for his children, so does the Lord care for those who fear Him. For He follows us, He remembers that we are the dust. Our days are like the grass, we flourish like the flower in the field. The merciful goodness of the Lord endures forever for those who fear Him, and His righteousness on His children's children, on those who keep His covenant and remember His commandments and do them. The Lord has set His throne in heaven, and His King has made it all. Bless the Lord, the kingdoms of His, you mighty ones, through the bidding, and hearken to the voice of His word. Bless the Lord, all His hosts, you ministers of His, as you do His will. Bless the Lord, all His hosts, in all places of His dominion. Bless the Lord, all my soul.
A reading from Paul's second letter to the Corinthians. We entreat you on behalf of Christ, be reconciled to God. For our sake, He made Him to be sin who knew no sin, so that in Him we might become the righteousness of God. As we work together with Him, we urge you also not to accept the grace of God in vain. For He says, at an acceptable time I have listened to you, and on the day of salvation I have helped you. See, now is the acceptable time. See, now is the day of salvation. We are putting no obstacle in anyone's way, so that no fault may be found in your ministry. But as servants of God, we have commended ourselves in every way. Through great endurance, in afflictions, hardships, calamities, beatings, imprisonments, riots, labors, sleepless nights, hunger. By purity, knowledge, patience, kindness, holiness of spirit, genuine love, truthful speech, and the power of God, with the weapons of righteousness for the right hand and for the left, in honor and dishonor, in ill repute and good repute. We are treated as impostors, and yet we are true, as unknown and yet are well known, as dying and see we are alive, as punished and yet not killed, as sorrowful yet always rejoicing, as poor yet making many rich, as having nothing and yet possessing everything. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Amen.
sin, you have no reward from your Father in heaven. So whenever you do wrong, do not sound the trumpet before you, as the hypocrites do in the synagogues and in the streets, so that they may be praised by others. Truly I tell you, they have received their reward. But when you give alms, do not let your left hand know what your right hand is doing, so that your alms may be done in secret. And your Father who sees in secret will reward you. And whenever you pray, do not be like hypocrites, for they love to stand and pray in the synagogues and on the street corners, so that they may be seen by others. Truly I tell you, they have received their reward. But whenever you pray, go into your room and shut your door, and pray to your Father who is in secret. And your Father who sees in secret will reward you. And whenever you fast, do not look as monks, like the hypocrites, for they disfigure their faces so as to show others that they are fasting. Truly I tell you, they have received their reward. But when you fast, put oil on your head and wash your face, so that your fasting may be seen not by others, but by your Father who is in secret. And your Father who sees in secret will reward you. Do not store up for yourself treasures on earth, where moth and rust consume, and where thieves break in and steal. But store up for yourselves treasures in heaven, where neither moth nor rust consumes, and where thieves do not break in and steal. For where your treasure is, there your heart will be also.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
Pay attention to the looks you get. perhaps a conversation will arise with the cashier or the server. They might ask you questions about the smudge on your face, or don't forget, or not know that it's Ash Wednesday, and you feel like this, you're like it off. But take notice to the reactions that you get. Maybe it might even start an interesting conversation with some folks, or back in faith, and bring maybe some of the folks to their relationship with Christ. But as we know, these outward signs that we'll receive tonight is not why we participate in Ash Wednesday. Historically, for 10 centuries, Christians have honored this Ash Wednesday tradition as the first day of Lent. We come together tonight to do the same thing as a long period and procession of Christians who have come before us. Nowhere in the Bible are we commanded to receive ashes on Ash Wednesday, or as a holy day. And in fact, Christians in turn recognize that the Bible is holy day either. In early centuries, Christians who repented their sins, and this is described in the Old Testament, they sprinkled ashes on their bodies to repent for their sins. And around the 10th century, that's when all of us as believers needed, we wanted to feel connected to Christ's story, and we have repentance by having ashes imposed on our foreheads in the shape of the cross. So tonight we're following these four footsteps, and it marks the beginning of 40 days of preparation leading up to Easter. And this practice comes directly from Scripture. This Sunday, we're going to hear about Christ's ministry starting with his 40 days in the wilderness. And this time when he prayed, fasted, and prepared himself, it was a time of contemplation, reflection, and preparation. And by observing Lent, many of us could choose to join Jesus on his journey. Well, most of us probably don't choose to go off into the desert and eat nothing for 40 days. We do choose to fast or pray, maybe choose to give something up, sacrifice something, deprive ourselves of something, so that we can contemplate on the true meaning of Lent. Perhaps reflect on Christ's ultimate sacrifice for his dying for us on the cross. And prepare for the celebration of the coming Easter and his resurrection. Episcopalian writer Marcus Ford says that Ash Wednesday is the most honest day of the year. And I have to agree with that. Time when we kind of put it all out there, don't we? We ask God for forgiveness for the year, maybe things that we feel sorry for, happy for, but also just remembering his ultimate sacrifice. And that is for us to have eternal life. And we say, remember that you are God's, and it's just you shall return. To remind us of our own mortality. Each one of us will die, and again, we're promised eternal life because of the death of our Savior. Lent is also a time of putting ourselves in a problem mindset. That mindset of knowing how much we really do need Jesus in our life. We're broken, perhaps sinful, imperfect, and that's when they offers us an opportunity to admit that we are human and have humility. You know, the scripture says, Jonah, no piety. We're not here for ourselves. We're here to practice our faith and show God's love to others. Letting go of our own wants and desires. Putting our spiritual life into practice. That's the righteous actions that Jesus speaks about. And the life that he lived. So to take this first step through our Lenten journey, I want you to think about why you would choose to walk around with a cross-shaped smudge on your forehead. What does that mean to you in your faith, in your walk, in your faith journey? And how do you respond to people when they ask you about those? And consider that when we get ashes, it's not just a ritual. Not trying to prove something to God. He tells us don't walk around like, you know, we're great. Consider that we might be getting them for ourselves. We can't see the ashes unless we look in the mirror. And then you go to look. That's what Lent is for. Exactly that. To look in that spiritual mirror. To look deeply and prayerfully into your soul and see what's lacking, what we will yearn for, or maybe reflect on how we can get our lives back on track. The ashes remind us that we're human, God loves us, and but we're human beings with free will. We make mistakes from time to time, and we need our Lord. So as true friends of Christ this Lent season, let's remember to watch and pray and stand beside Him on Monday, Thursday. To not flee from Him from the cross on Good Friday. And that we need to stand beside Him during this 40-day journey in the wilderness. And if we do, we're going to find that joy on Easter morning. And it will be so much sweeter because you understand the sacrifice of Christ too. Let's continue to trust our God that He's gracious and loving and forgiving, and it's not about the cross, the smudges on our forehead, but how we feel about Him, about our relationship with God, our relationship with our neighbors, and allow God to move freely within me during this time of season. And if you're at the Walmart and somebody asks you a question about the smudge on your head, tell them it's because you love God and He loves you. Dear people of God, the first Christians observed with great devotion the days of our Lord's Passion and Resurrection, and it became the custom of the Church to prepare for them by a season of penance and fasting. The season of Lent provided a time in which converts to the faith were prepared for holy baptism. It is also a time when those who, because of notorious sins, have been separated from the body of the faithful, were reconciled by penitence and forgiveness and restored to the fellowship of the Church. Thereby the whole congregation was put in mind of the message of pardon and absolution set forth in the Gospel of our Savior, and of the need which all Christians continually have to renew their repentance and faith. I invite you, therefore, in the name of the Church, to the observance of Holy Lent by self-examination and repentance, by prayer and fasting and self-denial, and by reading and meditating on God's holy word, and to make a right beginning of repentance. And as a mark of our mortal nature, let us now kneel before the Lord, our Maker and Redeemer. Almighty God, you created us out of the dust of the earth. Grant that these ashes may be a sign to us a sign of our mortality and penitence, that we may remember that it is our only, only by your gracious gift that we are given everlasting life. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior. Amen.
Thank you.
feel normal with it. So it got a little extra feeling to my job. Bruce, I respond to everyone in the room. Have mercy on me, O God,
according to your love and kindness, and your great compassion, that of my sins. I wash you with the truth of your goodness. I cleanse you from my sin. I am no longer confessed. My sin is ever before me. Yet still I have my sins. And I'm not of evil in your sight. And so you are justified when you see. And upright in your presence. Indeed, I have been wicked from my birth, a sinner from my mother's son. For behold, I look upon me, and will make me understand bliss and secret. Purge me from my sin, and I shall be pure. Wash me, and I shall be clean indeed. Make me hear, but the body you have broken me is yours. Hide your face from my sins, and blot out all my iniquities. Create in me a clean heart, O God, and renew a right spirit within me. Cast me not away from your presence, and take not your Holy Spirit from me. Give me the joy of your taking me out again. Sustain me with your bountiful spirit. And sinners I turn to you. Deliver me from death, O God. My tongue shall sing in praise. O God of my salvation, open my lips, O Lord, and my mouth shall proclaim my praise. And it is granted, I would have offered sacrifice. But you take not the light and burn up. The sacrifice of God, the troubled spirit, a broken and contrite heart, O God, you will not despise. Most holy and merciful Father, we confess that we have sinned against you, and to God, and to the saints. And we have sinned in our own thought and thought, word and deed, by what we have done, by what we have left undone.
We have not loved you with our whole heart and mind and strength. We have not loved our neighbors and ourselves. We have not forgiven others, and we have been forgiven.
Have mercy on us, Lord.
We have been deaf to your call to serve as Christ served us. We have not been true to the mind of Christ. We have grieved your Holy Spirit.
Mercy on us, Lord.
We confess to you, Lord, all our past unfaithfulnesses, the pride, hypocrisy, and impatience of our lives.
We confess to you, Lord,
our self-indulgent appetites and ways, and our exploitation of other people.
We confess to you, Lord,
our anger and our frustration and our envy of those more fortunate than ourselves.
We confess to you, Lord,
our intemperate love of worldly goods and comforts and our dishonesty and daily life of work.
We confess to you, Lord,
our negligence in prayer and worship and our failure to command the faith of that is in us.
We confess to you, Lord.
Accept our repentance, Lord, for the wrongs we have done, for our blindness to human need and suffering, and our indifference to the injustice and cruelty.
Accept our repentance, Lord,
for all false judgments, for uncharitable thoughts towards our neighbor, and for our prejudice and contempt towards those who differ from us.
Accept our repentance, Lord,
for our waste and pollution of your creation, and our lack of concern for those who harm our fellow.
Accept our repentance, Lord,
restore us, O Lord, and let your anger depart from us.
Favorably hear us, and your mercy is great.
Accomplish in us the work of your salvation.
That we may show forth your glory in the world.
By the cross and passion of your Son, our Lord.
Bring us all our saints to the joy of his resurrection.
Almighty God, have mercy on us. Forgive us all our sins through our Lord Jesus Christ. Strengthen us in all goodness and by the power of the Holy Spirit. Keep us in eternal life.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And also with you.
Let us greet each other with a sign of peace.
Thank you.
in the calling of Israel to be your people, in the word spoken through the prophets, and above all, in the word made flesh, Jesus your Son. During these last days, you sent him to be incarnate from the Virgin Mary, to be Savior and Redeemer of the world. In him, you have delivered us from evil and made us worthy to stand before you. In him, you have brought us out of error into truth, out of sin into righteousness, and out of death into life. By him and with him and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever.
Amen.
And now, as our Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to say, Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Christ our Passover, the sacrifice for us.
Therefore, let us keep the peace.
Thank you.
Thank you.